Maury Strong, a UN official credited with launching the environmental movement.
It's not truly really about saving the planet from carbon dioxide. It's about making money
at an
international level. We're not even talking here about country. We're talking about a global type money-making thing, correct?
Yes. We're talking about a powerful, immense aristocracy that has the intention of using the fear of the environment deteriorating. They're going to use it to take over the world.
I'm just delighted to have this opportunity of introducing to you Edmund de Rothschild.
Maurice Strong was in charge of the conservation movement, but he was also Edmund de Rothschild's right-hand man. You have money and the environment in one person, okay. Edmund de Rothschild. Now, Maurice Strong, I found out during that conference, was the point man, the one that was making the decisions.
And their aims are what?
Their aims are to create an anxiety about global warming to such a fevered pace that they're willing to accept a bank that will accept the responsibility for cleaning up the environment, and the bank will not be a friendly bank. So we have the establishment of a World Conservation Bank that will oppose industry, supposedly, but the aristocrats will cash in on the conservation projects. They told us that it would be great to have one bank because then we'd only have one currency.
So this is really about like an all-world government is what you're talking about.
It's here. Part of the one world order.
So Maurice Strong had an agenda from the start. A world bank. One currency. Everything under one roof,
one house.
This flies in the face of competition. This is a monopoly.
Oh no, it's not competitive, it's cooperation.
That's simple.
Do you really believe
that's what their plan is? Do you think they can succeed?
Yes.
Really, why?
They're smarter than we are.
George Hunt might have a point. Maurice Strong proposed a one world bank. Within a few years, countries began throwing away their own currencies and adopting the euro. In each case, the citizens have a little less power. Their futures are decided by some outside group. And now there's a call for a new global currency to replace the dollar. And it comes from the UN.
And that comes as no surprise to Jesse, the UN, the longtime base of Maurice Strong.